Dear all, have you heard the name Fatima Manassi? Fatima Manassi was born in a middle-class family in Morocco in 1940 and considered a pioneer of feminist writing in the Arab world and an internationally acclaimed Islamist feminist. Fatima Manassi is a sociologist and a teacher by profession, currently working in the Mohammed V University of Rabat. As a sociologist, she has done a substantial amount of fieldwork, mainly in her country, Morocco. Working for the UNESCO and ILO, she conducted many interviews in the late 1970s and 1980s in order to map the prevailing attitudes toward women and work. She has written extensively on women issues, women in Morocco's society, as well as on women and Islam from a historical and contemporary perspective, and has been widely published in magazines, journals and newspapers around the world. Because of her extensive work, she was awarded Prince of Asturias Award along with Suzanne Sontag in 2003. In her writing, she analyzes the historical development of Islamic thought and its modern manifestation and critiques women's role in it. This she does by a detailed investigation of the nature of the succession to Prophet Muhammad. She questioned the validity of some of the hadith on the issues of the subjugation of women in Islam, but not in the Quran. The central themes of her writing are based on the life of women within harem, question of gender and women's place and role in the public as well as private sphere. Her works have been translated into both English and French and therefore have a worldwide reach. Her works in English include Beyond the Veil, Male-Female Dynamics in a Muslim Society, 1975, which was revised in 1985 and 1987, Doing Daily Battles, Interviews with Moroccan Women, translated by Mary Jo Lakeland, in 1988, The Veil and the Male Elite, A Feminist Interpretation of Islam, in 1992, Forgotten Queen of Islam, 1993, Women, Rebellion and Islamic Memory in 1993, The Harem Within, which was retitled Dream of Test Pass, Tales of a Harem Girlhood in 1995, Shahzade Goes West 2001, and Islam and Democracy, Fear of the Modern World 2002. She believes in the theory that Islam does not subjugate women, rather it celebrates female power. In Beyond the Veil, Male-Female Dynamics in a Muslim Society, Manassi argues that Islam had given many rights to women. Indeed, in contemporary society, that fact so many women are working in various sectors in Arab society, including show anchors, films and video stars in more than 500 plus Arab satellite channels telecast around the globe is evidence of this. Sexual inequality, which is a major issue and hindrance to women's progress, is not peculiar to Islamic societies alone, but is a global phenomenon, a problem common to both Western and Islamic societies. In the book, Fatima Manassi stated that there was a perception among Muslim theorists that women as active sexual beings required stricter regulation and control, since inherent in that sexuality was a potential danger to civilized society. A perception not confined to the Islamic world alone, but found in patriarchal societies and religion the world over. However, with the advent of modernization, the prevalence of traditional Muslim structure are becoming less stringent and are giving into more flexible arrangement compatible with the woman modern world. Further, she clarifies her viewpoint through popular source material, exploring the disorienting effect of modern life on the present condition of male-female relation, and examines the male-female unit as a basic component of framework of Muslim orderliness, reflecting the sexual dynamics of the Muslim world to the reader. Beyond the Veil, Male-Female Dynamics in a Muslim Society is regarded as a classic book in the United States. Earlier, it was not available in the Britain, but now the revised and updated version is available around the world. So in this way, we can see that she has done a lot of work in the field of Islamic feminism. And now other women are also following her footsteps. Thank you.